Sky Technology Private Limited. My name is Ashwin Datta, and today we are going to discuss about phase lock loop IC565, and its order code is 36190. So in this video, we are going to discuss about its working. Now let's talk about the working of this kit. So for that, we have to do an experiment. That is to study and measure the free running frequency or center frequency of VCO. So for that, we have to do the connections first. We will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one and this port to this one and this port to this one and this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. So that is how the connection is done. You can see the connection in the manual also. Now we will connect the CRO probe to this port of IC, and the other end of the CRO to the ground port, this one. Now we will switch on the power supply and we will switch on the CRO. So here we can see that on the CRO the square wave is showing. Now we can increase the frequency or adjust the frequency through this knob. So here we can see that the frequency varies, and that is how this experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the VCO sensitivity. So for that we have to do the connections first. We will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. Then we will connect this port to this one. then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one, then we will connect this port to this one. So that is how the connection is done. You can see the connection in the manual also. Now firstly we will remove this VR1 port for the calculation. Now we will switch on the main supply, then we will connect one port of CRO to the IC pin 4 and the other port of the CRO to the ground one. Now we will switch on the CRO. So here on the CRO we can see that the current frequency is about 4.02 kHz. Now we will connect the VR1 port. And we will adjust the voltage around 1.6 volt at port 7. So we will adjust it through multimeter. We will connect the positive terminal of multimeter to the 7 port of IC and the ground terminal of the multimeter to the ground port. Now we will decrease the voltage through this port. So currently the voltage is 4.25 volt. We have to adjust it at 1.6 volt through this voltage controller. So here on the multimeter we can see that the current voltage is 1.6 volt approx. So now we can see the frequency on the DSO, that is there is an increase of 0.47 kHz. And now the frequency is around 4.75. So that is how the experiment is performed. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study the VCO linearity. So the connection will be same as the earlier experiment. We have to again remove this VR1 connection for the calculation. Now we will switch on the power supply and we will switch on the DSO. So here we can see that square wave is showing on the CRO and the current frequency is around 4.07 kHz. Now we will connect this wire to the VR1. and now we will adjust the voltage along the IC7 port. So for that we have to connect the multimeter along it. So we have to adjust the voltage around 1.6. So now we can see that on the DSO the frequency is now around 4.09 kHz for 1.6 volt. Now we have to take 3-4 readings, like we have to increase the voltage. We can set it at 1.9. So at 1.9 volt the frequency is 4.15 kHz. So that is how you can take many other readings, like you can increase the voltage, you can set it at 2.23 volt and now the frequency is 4.25. So that is how, when we increase the voltage, the frequency also increases, and we can plot a graph between this voltage and the frequency, and we can see that the graph is linear, or we can see the straight line. So that is how this experiment is performed. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, like, share and subscribe to our channel.